So it's a great counter pick line. And somewhat Enigma, not really sure. But I don't know, picking Doom just to silence Lion, no, maybe it's a good bet. Of course, I'm not as good as these captains here, so maybe the captains know what they're doing. I mean, not maybe, of course they know what they're doing. It just, maybe I just can't see it yet. But, yeah, so, okay about the lanes, I'm guessing tri lane with Razor, then some with Doom. Because, I mean, at least it seems like it, because usually Windrunner is the solo lane hero, and the tri lane usually goes with Razor, so I'm guessing there is his home with Doom, which would be interesting. I mean, he has a Devour, so I guess he would have an easy time farming, you know, against any, well, basically against the Shadow King, because I'm guessing the Shadow King would be there. Although maybe the Alchemist can go solo with, I mean, we've seen solo with Alchemist, although I'm guessing he's gonna go to a tri lane with Jakira and maybe Lion, and then the long lane goes for Enigma. But I will see how it goes, and I'm gonna pause the game, and we do have an observer these games, so good for me. I can keep the Fog of War this time. And, you know, I talked last time about, you know, why my map is black. I want to reiterate this point once again for you guys who haven't watched my previous replay. Go and watch them, by the way. I mean, do go and watch them. Yeah, if you're watching this one, if you like this one, I have three more, I think, already made. And I think I'm getting better and better with each replay, so... I mean, the previous ones are not as good as this one. Well, hopefully, I mean, this one will be good, so... But yeah, anyway. So I made the point previous game that my map is black because I prefer black minimaps. I just played this way for a thousand of years now. Okay, not a thousand, but like at least 8 years now, maybe. I play with black minimap. And... especially when you're observing heroes, like hero dots on the minimap are so much easier to see. And actually, I don't have... we have a first engagement? Maybe. And yes, sure enough... oh, Windrunner is actually at bottom as well. But I'm pretty sure she's going to go somewhere else. Top lane, arguably. Enigma just scares Doom from the room. While they're waiting the room. So basically, I'm also not using team colors because I just prefer seeing which hero is which, you know, the different colors of the heroes. Again, it's just easier for me to distinguish them. So we do have not really a gang. I don't want to call it a gang, but anyway, just bully Oh, he's going to kill the... No, he's not going to kill the regeneration room. Yes, he is going to kill the regeneration room, so... I mean, it kind of sucks when, you know, the first room that spawns is the regeneration room, because, I mean, there's nothing really you can do with the regen room at, like, 20 seconds into the game. So, yeah, it kind of sucked there, but, whatever. They just got a few free hits on Doom, so that's all good. So, we do have the Windrunner solo mid. Interesting. Not really, you know, unseen. And we'll just have to see how he fares against... G on Nevermore, who is of course the soulmate, and Kuroky, oh yeah, of course Kuroky, is gonna play the Windrunner. And bottom lane we have D-Tri lane, yes, with Light on Alchemist, and AA4 on Lion, and Vampire is gonna play my man of the, you know, my favorite hero in this game, Jakira, is gonna be played by Vampire. So pretty potent tri lane. Quite a lot of stuns. I'm guessing he's gonna take Ice Path, so we will have like 3 stuns in here. So, and of course, one slow. And more than 3 stuns actually, because he's gonna get Hex as well, so we're gonna have like 4 stuns and 1 slow. So, really potent tri lane. Well, here we do have. So, here we do have Miracle playing Crystal Maiden and Azen. Okay, Azen plays the Razor, while they're just duking it out. I mean, yeah, that's what you're supposed to do, by the way. Kuroky is doing the right thing. They're duking it out with Nevermore before he can get his soul counted up. Because Nevermore early game, like really, really early game for the first couple of levels, Nevermore is just a weak link. So basically, if you're a good early game hero, you can just rape him if you wish. Well, Doom almost goes down to Enigma. This lane is gonna go to Enigma pretty surely. Dread is on Enigma, so watch out for this Enigma player. While Pashcat is on Doom, so I'm really rooting for him as well. So we have Vampire on Jakira and Pashcat Doom, so he's doing some pulling. Good for him. He hasn't eaten any neutral creeps yet, so no, you know, extra abilities for him. He got a Dread, no, G got a Immersion Rune, so good for him. Although, you know, he doesn't have his bottle yet, so you know, I don't think it's that big of a deal. Tri-lane, we have a tri-lane versus tri-lane, which is always good, you know, because otherwise we just see a tri-lane against a solo hero, and then we just see a solo hero get raped, you know, for the first 5 minutes of the game or so. While, you know, in both sides, you know, respectively for each team, you know, the tri-lane just raped the solo hero. While, here they did nothing more. I mean, they just keep changing damage back and forth. Probably power shots against raises. And both of them are trying to wither the other hero down. Nothing really happening. The Doom is trying to bitch slap Enigma. And he's doing a pretty good job bitch slapping Enigma, to be honest. But I don't think that any kills would happen in the top or mid lanes. I'm probably guessing, because both of these tri lanes are pretty potent offensively. So I'm guessing that the first blood would come from here, somewhere. So I'm guessing Enigma would win the lane against Doom. Doom would not be like really heavily outfarmed because he has his Devour and whatever, but I still think that Enigma would easily win the lane. Like, as I said, not like really huge difference or whatever, but he'll still be able to easily win the lane, I think. Level 5 Nevermore is gonna start beating Windrunner, I would say. Because Windrunner is a good hero, you know, definitely, don't get me wrong, she's a good hero. But, and trying to get the regen room, but the only thing he can do is cancel it. Yeah. Oh no! He has a bottle already, so good fight for him. And he bottles the regen room. So, although, you know, Windrunner's best efforts, you know, he couldn't get the room. So, he has a bottle as well. I mean, she, not he. Look at his boobs, I mean, how can, you know, a little bit of heat, unless, you know, she's a really fat dude. Yeah, we have a third blood, and actually this is a really huge third blood for the Scourge team, because they managed to get Light, who is one of the other team's primary carries. So really nice start, I would say, for GGNet. The kill went to Witch Doctor. Oh, it doesn't really matter. We have a dive on this. No, I don't think that Nevermore can kill the Windrunner, especially with you know, these kind of raises. You know, clearly he's not the athlete, so. Crystal Maiden almost dies, you know, instead they just turn the gank around. This is what I'm talking about. Really nice ice law. Whoa. So instead they turn the gank around and kill Lion. So almost getting the Crystal Maiden, but instead they lose the line. So tri-lane versus tri-lane, I have to say that, you know, obviously the Scourge tri-lane has the upper hand, you know, at least for now. Which is strange, because I thought that, you know, Alchemist is a really tanky hero. Well, Razor, of course, is a bit tanky hero as well, but not yet. I mean, he needs his items to be tanked. Well, Alchemist is just tanky hero anyway. And, you know, with the support of Lion and Jakiro, I thought that... I don't know, I thought that the Sentinel would actually win the tri-lane. But apparently it's the other way around, so there goes my Dota knowledge, you know. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. He has eaten the Alpha, so now he has this crazy 30% attack speed aura, attack damage aura, and a critical strike. So that's what I like to do as well. Maybe, I mean, it's not that useful, you know, at this point of the game, because, I mean, you do like 70 damage, so 30% is not that much. Although, every little bit helps for last hitting, you know, creeps or whatever. But especially during late game, because even without many items, he has huge strength gain. I mean, I think he's the best strength gain in the game. While I miss a kill. On mid lane, actually, Kuroky gets a kill on Nevermore. So... pardon me, I missed a really interesting kill, probably, because I wasn't really expecting a kill to be happening here. Apparently, well, I think probably what happened is a really nice shackle shot into a power shot. Because, I mean, without the shackle shot, I don't think that, you know, he would be able to get him. While we do have Witch Doctor just lurking around, but he's spotted by this ward, so maybe we will have an alpha gank at some point on him. Because he's not the beefiest hero there is, and we do have Lion for disable and, you know, some raises as well. Yep, we have a disable, we have another one, and clutch shackle shot, but it's not enough. But I don't think he's gonna get the kill though. It's basically just Witch Doctor just dies. Although, you know, the best efforts of Windrunner to save him with a really clutch shackle shot. But then again, I mean, if you go against Lion, who can just pin you down for, you know, Nevermore to position himself with his raises, then it's pretty much a sure kill, especially if you're a Witch Doctor, you know, you have like 500 HP or something. I mean, okay, a bit more. Yeah, okay, 500 HP or something. So yeah, it was a pretty easy kill. Doom diving for Jukiro, cancelling his TP and getting very nice wand there, but maybe Jukiro is gonna escape. I'm really provoking with the idol wand there. So yeah, Jukiro escapes. And yes, you know, my favorite hero hasn't died yet, so great. Although, you know, my other favorite hero didn't get a kill, so, you know, it's kind of a trade-off. It doesn't really matter. I mean, really pro blocking with, you know, with the idol wands there from Dread. But what do you expect, you know, is Dread. So this is a former gank on Doom, so basically Doom just has no choice but just, you know, go and die, basically. It's kind of funny, you know, maybe, you know, when Doom dies, maybe he goes to hell, because it's his place, right? I mean, like, he's a demon, and he kind of looks like Lucifer. I mean, yeah, actually, his name is Lucifer, so basically, yeah, he's the devil. So maybe, you know, when he dies, he goes to hell, and he just goes home, you know, just chills, has a bit of cocktails, you know, burns a few people there, and, you know, has a bit of fun, and then just returns and tries to doom people in here, so. You know, it's a really interesting idea, you know, to think about it, you know, doom the Lucifer. You know, trying to really nice power shot. Always, you know, with AoE nukes like this, always try to get as many creeps as possible when you're trying to farm. One of the towers already goes down, as well as with the other. So once again, the tri-lane here is apparently really strong. But then, I mean, it's a big of a surprise because we do have Witch Doctor's puppy on Witch Doctor. He's actually tanking quite a lot of damage. So we do have Voodoo Restoration from him. So they should be a really potent. Pushing lane, and now this ward is gonna screw their ganking attempts, big time. Yep, this ward just screws them over, because they just walk right past it, and they actually put another one. So these two just tear each other. Although they actually can't, because they need a little blue ward as well. Because right now they're just sitting next to each other, chilling. You know, almost touching hands. Touching eyelids or whatever, but you know, although they're touching eyelids, they still can't really see each other. So, you know, still it's good because you know, they don't feel lonely. Although they don't know that you know, there is another world next to them. But still, it's always good, you know, to have a little, you know, nice partner world next to you. Whatever, doesn't matter. They do get middle tower as well, which is quite big, especially, you know, as I said, for Roshan battles. This is the closest Sentinel tower to Roshan area. Doom is gonna be okay, definitely. Actually, Enigma must be careful, you know, instead of Doom. And Jukiro just TPs, and this time there is no Doom to actually cancel his TP, so he's gonna be fine as well. Yeah, so just one tower down, and this is arguably the most unimportant tower. For Scourge, while we do have two quite important towers, the bottom one and especially the mid one, already down for Sentinel. So I'm guessing that the early game advantage would go to GGNet, which is kind of surprising because I thought that DTS would have a fairly easy early game with a fair amount of nukes disabled and a Razor is going down. As well as with Crystal Maiden, because, oh yeah, Crystal Maiden is an ulti, and she's definitely gonna go down. Oh! Okay, I caught it a bit too early. Really nice wand there, magic wand, just saves the day. Jukiro gets doomed, really nice shackle shot into a power shot, I'm guessing. Or maybe not. No, he's gonna die anyway. No! Come on! Oh no, he is gonna die, really nice power shot. So I'm really impressed with Olivia's play so far.